What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Hey, man, I got the brand new Harbinger LV8 mixer. And I'm going to show you all about it right here, right now, on this channel. It's about to go down. So, you ready? Here we go. All right, so this is the LV8 mixer by Harbinger. Now, this is a very light, you know, easy to carry around. So if you're doing some type of gig in a restaurant or maybe of a bar or something like that, or maybe just some type of outside street gig in a park or something like that, this is going to be a really, really nice thing to carry around because it's not very heavy. So it's, you know, you can definitely carry that around and tote it. So let's go through the nuances of this product. So on channels 1 and 2, they're exactly the same. They're mainly set up for vocal mics. So what you wanna do, you can use a condenser mic or a regular mic, but it's gonna be either XLR or it's gonna be a 1/4-inch mic jack that you wanna be able to plug in. Now on this, because it does have the capability of having the 48 volt side, you can use the condenser mics that require 48 volts. Just press that in and the light will turn on and you'll hear the difference because it'll power it. But it also has the pad and the 80 hertz roll off for the bass and treble side to get that pops and clicks out of microphones that might happen in this style of microphone when you're out in a live setting. So this is going to really be a good use case scenario for that type of microphone. So on channels 1 and 2, you're going to have that. Additionally, on channel 1 and 2, you have your gain. Now on the gain side, most people don't quite, they use gain a little bit wrong, but gain is typically used when the input signal is too low. And you just wanna boost that gain before it hits the EQ, before it hits the preamps, everything. You wanna make sure that you're giving the amps and everything something to work with. And so you wanna boost these two up. In addition here, as mentioned, you do have an EQ, and on this particular model, they introduce the 3-band EQ. So you have high, mid, and low EQs that you can work with and kind of tailor that sound, whether it's roll off some bass or whatever, and get that sound the way you want. You also have pan left to right. So if you had two vocals and you just kind of wanted to separate them a little bit and let them float, you know, so that you get that little stereo effect going on in the crowd, this would be a good way you would do that. You would pan those off either way. You could do a hard pan. I don't think I would do a hard pan in a live situation, but you could do that if you like. And then you have the actual volume or gain, volume up on this, where you're bringing this up and bringing it into the mix and making it more balanced in your mix. And so you can set the vocals. If you got one person who sings a little harder than the other person, this will give you the ability to actually balance those two vocals out so that they're on the same field of play while they're singing. So now let's go over to channel, let's go to channel 3 and 4. On channel 3 and 4, it's a little unique because channel 3 and 4 give you two things. One involves being a stereo input left and right. So if you had, say, a keyboard or something like that, or maybe an electronic drum set or something you want to plug in, you could do that there. But I wouldn't do that there if I had a guitar player, because you have the ability on here to have the guitar, bass, or a guitar player on that channel. You can literally plug those in and you would hit this button, and what it would do is it would change the impedance of the input to match what is necessary for a guitar or a bass, giving you like a direct box would do, giving you that ability to boost that signal and mix that thing into your whatever you're doing. Now on this channel here, because you have 3 and 4, you have the ability to turn, you have your gain again if it's too low, you have your EQ again, skipping sin. You can balance it the way you want with those instruments. And of course, if they have those, they're gonna be able to turn their gains up on their rigs or whatever. And then you can balance it into the mix with the fader here. That brings us over now to channels 5 and 6. On 5 and 6, this is where if I'm doing a live situation and I got a guitar or bass player and maybe I got a keyboard player, or I'm playing keys and singing at the same time or something like that, I would plug in here, left and right here, and then, or you could do mono if you just have one thing that you want to plug in, but you plug in left and right. Again, you have your gain on that channel, your EQ, you can balance that out. So if I got my guitar, maybe I got my guitar in the center, and I want to pull my piano off to the side a little bit, or off to one side, and I got my drums in the center, or maybe I just got my drums and keys in the center, I want my guitar and vocal. Whatever you want to do, that's where you want to do that with your balance. And then I can bring it up, of course, in my fader. So now let's go to Now that we got those two, you have a couple of more things that you can do here, and I'll talk about this before I get to the other inputs. So you have control room out. Now this is really cool. So let's say if I'm using this in my personal studio and this is my main board, okay? You can have these going to a set of speakers in that studio and see so that you can get that sound separate from your house sound, which are your main outs. So I can put those out like that and I can come back to some type of control room or some type of speaker system that's separate where I can listen to what's going on and see what my mix sounds like in that situation in, you know, in my setup. So that's really cool. Then you have your send out and your send return, and that's why I wanted to wait on the sends. This keyboard introduces up from the LV7, begins to introduce the send. So I'll explain that like this. If you have a situation where you have your main speakers up, and now as a vocalist, I'm singing, I want to be able to hear myself and maybe some of the mix. That's what the send is for. I can send, well, one of the things this is for, I can send that sound through the sends to a separate mix for, and create the separate mix for the mix, the monitors that are sitting in front of me. So I have a monitor on the floor that's facing me versus what's going out. And this doesn't have to have the same balance and instrumentation going through. So if all I wanna hear is the guitar, very little drums, and my vocal, or maybe I don't even wanna hear my vocal, I just wanna hear a little piano and the drums, I can hear what that sounds like, or just wanna hear only one thing, I can hear that one thing coming to me, and that's how you would get that out to that. And so you also, so that's how you do that, and you have your volume control, the master, come up for that. But now you have a return. So what is the send return? So here's what happened. If I have some type of off-board rig that does some type of signal processing, whether it be some type of amp or whatever, just whatever that thing is, that I wanna process the vocal or I wanna process the keys or whatever into that and bring it back into the mix, I can, and it'll come back through the return in. Now, the thing you gotta remember when you do that is when you do that, it comes in and it goes straight to the main out. So whatever you're bringing in, you gotta make certain that you got that thing set the way you want it, because once it comes back, it's coming back and going straight out. You got me? So just wanna make sure you understand that. You can control the volume of it, you can control the, you know, all of that right here, but you just wanna make certain that you understand that that's what that's doing when you bring it back. So you're taking the signal out into to something that some type of situation offside. There's so many different things, so I won't try to name one particular thing, but you're gonna take it out to some type of processor, EQ, whatever it might be, bring that back, bring it back in, mix it back into the total mix of what you got going on, and go right back out. So that's how that works. Now, let's go to, come down to 7 and 8. I know I skipped those, but I want to come back to those. 7 and 8, I can't do that because you're dealing with either Bluetooth, where let's say I Bluetooth my computer or Bluetooth my phone or some iPad, because somebody's coming to sing with us and they got their music on the iPad and they want to Bluetooth it in. I can Bluetooth their music in, mix it into the mix, bring the volume up and all of that, get it mixed in like I want it, and boom, go right out to the main speakers, and everybody would think things just perfectly working perfectly. So you can do that. Or I can plug directly in and do the exact same thing. So it does have the capability of taking Bluetooth signal from somewhere or bringing in an external channel or external source through that 7 and 8 channel. And then you would just control your volume just like you would on everything else. And you could, you know, send it to where you need to and bring your volume up. Last is record out. If I wanted to record that session, I can send something out to a record device to record that session live or whatever, so I can have it. Maybe I want to mix and master it later. I don't know. I mean, you know, maybe I like the way it sounds and I just want to recreate it and play it back later, whatever you want to do. In addition, this last one is your master volume. This is how you turn everything up all at once. These individuals give you the individual control. This brings everything up, your master volume. Last but not least is you have your power on indicator and your clipping or monitor lights so that you can see how much volume you're actually putting out. Are you clipping? Do you need to bring something back? Do you need to turn everything down? That's what you get in there. So this little unit, oh, let me not forget, on the back, your power on and off switch and the proprietary cord that you saw on the previous one. So this is the LV7 by Harbinger. This is, replaces the current model that's, or the model that was out. This is the new one for this year. And this is a little powerhouse of a unit. Like I said, for someone that's doing a gig in a restaurant, at a bar, and you got a small band, maybe a couple singers and electric drums, just, you know, or you're just using your computer, you're like a one-man band type of setup. This, again, is a really good unit, gives you a lot of flexibility, and I think is one that you should definitely consider to add to your arsenal and go ahead and get. So, if you like this or you got any other questions, go to the comment section, ask me some questions. I'll try my best to answer all of those. You can also find the link to this product below. I'm not sponsored by Harbinger, so I get nothing if you buy this at all. Literally, I get absolutely nothing. They sent me this to review and to look at and tell what I think about it. And so far, based on what I've been able to just deduce from turning them on and checking them out, these things seem really, really good. I'm gonna eventually start putting these to the test in some different scenarios, so I can't wait to do that and get those videos up. But just getting it out the box and looking at it, going through what it can do, definitely, and having heard what it sounds like, definitely think this is definitely something you should go. So listen, do me a favor, click the like button. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you ding the bell so that you can catch all of the new videos that are getting ready to come out. And once again, man, thank you so much for tuning in right here at Music Gear Reviews. I appreciate you, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace.